Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you about non-destructive editing. It's hugely important topic to understand, but fortunately this is also simple. Non-destructive editing means working in a way that allows you to make changes to an image without altering the original image data, which remains available in case you want to revert to it. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I have a Gollum photo here. Let's say I'll make a selection on Gollum and the rock in front of him and erase the whole background right here. Let's look at what most people do when making a selection. We have the selection now. Press delete to erase the whole background. Now here's the problem. When you're working on selection, you're not always get a good selection. We have to refine it. If we look closer to the right arm right here, the bottom arm is erased, we need to refine it. How? Well, at this point, you can't get that erased part back. Because we completely lose the original image data. The only option we have is to undo the selection. Or we can go to history panel, right here. But how if we were much further along in our edit? Or how if we saved and closed the document? The history and the original image data is completely gone. So this would be considered a destructive edit. Because there is no longer way for us to go back to the original image. I will show you how to work with selection in non-destructive manner later on this video. Let's look at another example. Now we'll work on color adjustment. This is what most people do with adjustment edit. Go through image menu, adjustments. Let's say we want to edit the brightness and contrast. Hit OK. In this method, we apply the adjustments directly to the image. It means we lose the original image data. At this point, if you want to readjust the brightness or contrast, it starts from your edited data instead of the original. We lose the original image data. So this would be considered as destructive way. Okay, I hope you understand now why do we should use non-destructive editing. Trust me. It will save you a lot of hassle in the future. Well, in this video, I will show you how to work on selection, color adjustments, image retouching, transformation, and cropping in non-destructive way. Now, we will work on selection using layer masks. There are several tools to make selection in Photoshop. We can use mark tools, lasso tools, quick selection tool and magic wand tool, eraser tool, or using path tool. I'll talk about selection specifically in the next video, so make sure you subscribe to my channel, don't miss out my next video. Well, these selection tools are destructive if we apply it directly to our images. So, we need layer masks. Let's see how it works. Probably, you used to erase the part of the image using this eraser tool. But the problem is, it's destructive. It completely changed the original image. Let's use layer mask. The mask is located here. Okay, make sure you select the layer that will be applied to mask. Then, click the mask icon right here. Now, you can see. There is a white square on the right of the layer. You just apply the mask to that layer. Now we are ready to erase everything on the image. Make sure you select the mask instead of the layer itself. Then select the brush tool. And set the foreground to black. Now, you can erase everything. Just paint the part that you want to erase. If you make a mistake like that, it's not a big deal. What you have to do is just turn the brush color to white and paint it back in. That's the magic of layer mask. If you right-click on the mask and disable the layer mask, the original image remains available. And if we right-click again and enable the mask, we have the selection we made. And if we delete the layer mask, our selection is gone. But there is still the original image. Let's use selection tool. We'll try use the rectangular mark tool. Drag down here. And click the layer mask. We have the rectangular selection now. Let's try use another selection tool. Magnetic lasso tool. Let's make selection on the helmet of the stormtrooper. And click layer mask. We have stormtrooper helmet selection. It's very simple, right? Let's use quick selection tool. Then click layer mask. And we have the selection. If we look closer here, there are parts of the helmet being erased. That's not the big deal at all. Simply select the brush tool, turn the foreground to white, and paint it back in. It's fine now. Right now, probably you're wondering about using white and black brush. When do you use black? And when do you use white? Let me show you something. If you hold Alt at your keyboard and click the layer mask, we can see the layer mask view. The white part here is our selection, the visible part. And the black part is the hidden part. So, keep it in your mind. White part is visible, and the black part is hidden part. White, visible. Black, hidden. White, visible. Black, hidden. So, when you want to erase the image, use black brush. When you want to make the hidden part visible, use white brush. It's pretty simple, right? Layer mask also can be applied before we making selection. Let me show you. Select the layer. Then apply the mask. Make sure you select the mask, instead of the layer itself. Then you can start selecting the unwanted part that you want to erase with your favorite selection tools. In this case, I'll use quick selection tool. Okay, when you finish make a selection, you can start painting it with the black brush tool. Or, you can use paint bucket tool. Set the foreground to black. And click on your selection. With paint bucket tool, it can erase in only one click. Then go to select menu. Deselect. Or you can use shortcut Ctrl D, if you're on Windows. Or Command D if you're on Mac, to get rid of the marching ants. Now, I'll add a color background to my selection. I'll fill the background with black. We have Stormtrooper in the black background now. If we look closer to the selection edge doesn't look nice. It looks jagged. We need to refine it. If you double-click on the mask, we will get mask properties, right here. We will refine the selection with this. Let's take a look at density. If we set density lower, it will increase the opacity of the hidden part. Let's set to 0%. Look! The hidden part become visible. And if we set density back to 100%, the hidden part is back to transparent. What will happen if we set the density to lower than 100%? Let's set to 45% for example. Look at the layer mask, the hidden part turns from black to gray. If we double-click on it, we can clearly see it. So, whenever you see the layer mask, and has the gray color on it, it means the opacity is not set to 100. The erased part not fully erased. Okay, for now we don't need to set the density. Because we need the background to be fully removed. Below the density, we have feather. Let's set the feather higher. It will make the edge smoother. Just play around with this. Look! The edge looks nice now. It's not jagged anymore. Let's move to mask edge. This is the advanced setting to refine the mask edge. There is a view mode here. You can choose view mode as you want. It will not affect to our mask. It's just view mode. I'll use on black view. Below it, there is edge detection. And there is smooth setting here, to adjust the smoothness of the mask edges. Feather. And we have the contrast setting here to set the contrast of the edge. Shift edge. Just adjust the setting until you get that the edge looks smoother. The value of each setting would be different in any images. It depends on the size of the image, selection, and other factors. I think I'm done with the setting here. If we check the Show Original option right here, we can view the original mask. And if we disable, we have a view of the image after we refine the mask. I think it looks nicer now. Hit OK to apply our setting. That's it. That's all the basic of layer mask. Now, you can work on selection in non-destructive way. Whenever you need to refine or completely change the selection, or you need the original image, you simply paint back into the mask. Let's move on to part 2, we will work on image adjustments in non-destructive way. We'll work on adjustments in non-destructive way. In the beginning of this video, I've shown you the destructive way to apply adjustment on an image. It's go to image menu, adjustments. But, in my opinion, it's not a good way. Because it's completely changed your original image. So, whenever you want to readjust your image, you're done. There's no way to get back to your original image. So, instead of going to that image menu, we'll use adjustment layers. If you go to layer panel here, at the bottom, on the right side of the mask icon, you will see the adjustments layer. When we click it, there are some adjustments option. Brightness and contrast, level, curves, hue and saturation, etc. It also appears here. We have adjustments options here. If you don't see this panel in your workspace, you can go to Window menu, then click on Adjustments. It will appear right here. Now let's take some actions. We'll adjust the brightness and contrast to the image. Click this icon here, and choose Brightness Contrast. There is Brightness Contrast layer appears here, right above the layer. It also has a mask. Let's set the brightness and the contrast. Okay, we just apply the brightness and the contrast to the image. If you're not happy with the adjustment, you can simply hide the adjustment layer. If you want to get it back, just unhide it. Or, if you want to completely remove the adjustments, just drag the adjustment layer down. Or simply press delete button on your keyboard. Let's try with another adjustments. Hue and saturation. Drag down the saturation here, we'll make the image less color or maybe make it black and white, like that. We have a mask here, and let me show you one of the cool thing of this adjustment layer has. Select the brush tool. And set the color to black. Then, start painting right here. So, using a mask on the adjustment layer, allows us to apply the adjustment, only on the part of the image that we want. With this, we can make a color splash effect like that. It's quite cool, huh? Now, let's try to apply other adjustments together. I'm gonna set the level here. And photo filter. And curves, for example. If you're not happy with the last adjustments, you can simply hide the adjustment layers. Or delete it. That's it. Now you know how to work on adjustments in a non-destructive way. In this section, we'll talk about smart object. Still focusing on our main topic, non-destructive editing. Here I have Hot Toys King Leonidas picture. I really like this figure, one of my favorite in my collection. I edited this picture quite long ago, this is the PSD file. But I merged the layers and modify it for this video tutorial. And I think this picture is fit to demonstrate what I want to talk about right now. About smart object. Okay, I'll show you about what smart object is. How can smart object allows non-destructive editing? And what is the benefit of using it? I'll duplicate the Leonidas layer, and move the duplicated layer to the right. Then I'll convert the duplicated Leonidas layer to the smart object with right click on the layer. Then click convert to smart object. You can see the smart object icon appears on the layer. So, the left Leonidas is normal layer. And the right one, is smart object. Now, I'll select both layers. Then press Ctrl T, to transform these images. If you're on Mac, you can press Command T. Then drag it down here to transform these images to be smaller. Let's press the check icon right here to apply the transformation. And I'll transform these images back to be bigger. If we look at both images, you can clearly see, the left one, the normal layer, it looks blurry. But the right one, not. Okay, I'll zoom it in, so you can see it clearly. Let's press the check icon right here to apply the transformation. Let me drag the right Leonidas closer to the left one, so you can compare it. See? The normal layer looks blurred. So, what's the point? The point is, smart object keep maintain the original pixel data of the image. When we did transformation before, when we transform these images to be smaller, the pixel data of the normal layer is completely changed while the smart object not. So, when we transform it back to the bigger size, the original pixel data is remain available, if we use smart object. That's the first benefit of using smart object. It's useful when we working on transformation. It keeps the quality of the image, even we transform it multiple times. Smart object also useful, if we are working on filter. First, let me show you, what happen if we apply filter directly to the normal layer. Go to filter menu. I'll use filter blur, Gaussian blur. If we apply filter directly to the image, to the normal layer, it completely changes the original image. Now let's see what happen, if we apply the filter to the smart object. I'll convert the layer to the smart object first. Then go to the filter menu. Blur. Gaussian blur. You can see, after applying filter to the smart object, there is a child layer below the smart object, called smart filter. The filter is separate to the smart object. So, if we want to disable the filter, we simply hide it. And we can unhide it if we want. We have a full control to the filter after we apply it. It also has a filter mask, so we can select the part that we don't want to be applied filter. Like that. We can disable filter mask. We can delete filter mask. And, we can clear the filter completely, and we still got the original image here. That's the magic of smart object and smart filter. I'll show you another cool thing that smart object can do. I'll duplicate Leonidas layer. We have three smart object of Leonidas now. Double click on the smart object, it will show the warning here. Just hit OK. Then we will have a new tab, that consists only of the layer that we double clicked before. Let's make some changes on this layer. I'll use hue and saturation to change the color of this image. Let's change him to green. Then go to file, and save. Look! Our changes is not only affect to the selected smart object. But it also affect to the duplicated layers. Now if we want to edit it back to the normal. Simply double-click on the layer. Then delete the adjustment layer. And go to File. And save. Boom. It's pretty cool, right? This is very useful if you work with a lot of duplicate layers. Because you only need to make changes on one layer, and it will affect two other duplicated layers. It saves you a lot of time. In this section, we are gonna talk about photo retouching in non-destructive way. Stamp tool, burning tool, and dodge tool are the tools mostly used in the photo retouching. I'll show you how to use these tools in non-destructive way. We have Hot Toys the Joker picture here. If we look closer, you can see that my Joker figure has chipped nose here. We'll fix it with stamp tool. Okay, let's select the stamp tool. And, instead of apply it directly to the image, I'd rather apply it to the blank layer. Create a new layer by clicking this icon here. Now we have a new blank layer. Then go to the properties, on the sample, we have options, click and choose current and below. Now, we can start using stamp tool on the blank layer. Let's say we make a mistake, like that. It's not a big deal. If we go to layer panel, and hide the stamp tool layer here, we still have the original image. Because what we did, is applying stamp tool to the blank layer, instead of apply it, directly to the image. Let's unhide the stamp layer here, and fix our mistake. Select the eraser tool, and erase our mistakes. We are done. Now, we'll work on burn and dodge tools. In the world of photo retouching, the dodge and burn tools are very helpful when trying to lighten or darken specific areas of the photo. But, what a lot of people don't know, is that they don't need to be applied directly to the layer. Let me show you how to use these tools in non-destructive way. Unfortunately, we can't use transparent or blank layer for burn and dodge tool, like we did with stamp tool. We will create a filled layer, as if a transparent layer. First, let's create a new layer. Then, go to Edit, and Fill. And we'll fill the layer with 50% gray, so, choose 50% gray. Hit OK. Then, set blending mode to overlay. Look, we have a filled layer here, but it is as if transparent when we set the blending mode to overlay. If we hide the dodge and burn layer, we still have the original image available. Now we can start using burn and dodge tool without changing the original image. I'll use dodge tool to lighten the shadow here. And on his eyes. And burn tool to darken this area. Like that. If we set the blending mode back to normal, we can see what is actually we were doing here. Let's set the blending mode back to overlay. At this point, if you realize that your retouching is too much or over, you can simply set the opacity lower. Adjust it until you're happy with the result. That's it. That's how we retouch an image in non-destructive way. We are in the final section of the video. In this section, we'll learn how to crop an image in non-destructive way. Have you experienced something like this? Let's say you want to crop this image. Like that. And when you try to crop again, you lose the cropped area. If it happens, it really sucks. There is a simple trick for it. Here is the trick. When you crop the image, see at the properties. Make sure you uncheck the delete cropped pixels option. Let's crop the image. Maybe something like that. And click the check icon right here. That's it. Now, if you crop your image again, you can see the original image is still available there. You can crop the image, without worrying to lose your image parts. Now, if you want to reveal your original image, simply go to Image. Reveal All. Boom. You get your original image back. That's it all. We have learned about non-destructive editing in Photoshop. Hope you find this video useful. Please like and comment. or subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thanks.